Hey, I'm Galen from Local Creative Co. And in today's video, we're gonna be talking about how to remove the header section from a specific page on your Squarespace website. Now I'm gonna show you a few different ways to do this in the back end of Squarespace. All of them involve a little bit of custom CSS, but it's super simple, so stay tuned. First, we're gonna go into our design settings and click on custom CSS. Then you're gonna add this teeny little bit of code here. All it says is the word header, and then inside of the brackets here, it says display colon none. And what this does is it's going to hide the header section on every single page of our website. You can see if I delete this little bit of custom code here and hit save, we get the header back at the top. And if I add it again, we're going to see that it disappears. Super simple. The only problem with this is you probably don't want your header removed from every single page, just some pages in particular. If I want to hide a specific section on a particular page, I need to be able to tell Squarespace in the custom CSS which section I want to hide. So I'm going to delete header here, which again is targeting every single header on every page of my website. I'm going to come over here to my Squarespace ID Finder extension. It's a free extension you can find in the Google Chrome App Store. Very, very handy for anyone who is tinkering behind the scenes in Squarespace. I'm going to click on this extension and you can see all these little pop-ups appear on the page. If I want only the header hidden from this particular page, I'm gonna make sure I'm on the right page and I'm gonna click this collection ID up at the top, and then I'm going to paste that into this section here right where I had header before. But now you can see I still need the word header that was hiding the entire collection. Now it's hiding just the header from this particular page, and if I hit save, and we go check out another page on this site. Let's see, this is a demo site here, so I'm not sure what other pages we have available. Looks like we have an about page here. Let's click on that. You can see the about page still has the header, but the home page should be missing the header because we hid that with custom CSS. And you can do that with any section on any page. So instead of targeting this collection's header, we could also target a particular section. Typically, you don't want to hide sections on a page, but I just want to show you what this looks like. So you can see I just got rid of that section. Again, not sure why you'd want to do that, but maybe on a particular page you want to hide a section for some reason. This just sort of shows you how to do that. Even though this method works really well, there's a better way I found to hide headings on particular pages, specifically if you're using those pages as landing pages and you plan on creating quite a few of them. Instead of adding your custom CSS into this section here, we're actually going to go into the page specific CSS. So I'm gonna close this, I'm gonna come back here to my pages menu, and instead of, again, going into the design settings, I'm going to click on this little gear icon next to the page where I want to hide that header. I'm gonna click on the gear icon. It's gonna pull up the settings for just this page. I'm gonna click on advanced. And in the code area here, and keep in mind, you do need a business plan or higher on Squarespace to use any custom code, I'm gonna type in these style tags here. It's just open caret, the word style, closing caret. And then in this section, I am gonna put in exactly the same code we had before, header, and then curly brackets, display none. And when I hit save, this style is going to only apply to the page where I've added this advanced header code here. So let's check it. Style, heading, display none. Hit save here. And now you can see the heading is missing from this page, but if I click on to any of the other pages here, they will still have a heading, and that's exactly what we want. The nice part about doing this in the advanced custom code or the advanced header code injection or the advanced settings for a particular page, rather than in the general CSS area, is that if I wanted to create a landing page, for example, and then I wanted to create another landing page, typically I duplicate an existing page. And it's really nice because when you come in here and you duplicate an existing page that has that header code or has that header hidden, If I duplicate this page, the new page, the new clone of this page is also going to have that header code missing or have that header section missing. Whereas if I did this in the general CSS, I'd have to go back into the CSS, click on my Squarespace ID finder, find the collection, and then add that to my custom CSS. I think this is a lot easier. I only have to put the code in once on the very first landing page that I create, and then I just clone that page every time I want a new page with a header missing as well. Let me know in the comments if you'll be using this little trick on your website, and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any more videos we put out in the future. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.